Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel and today we will talk about how to compare two fractions or more than two fractions. Okay, and why should we know about it? Because to find out the greatest fraction, to find out the smallest fraction, to arrange the fraction in ascending order, in descending order, to find out this type of problem, we should know comparing the fractions. Okay, so first of all, we will know what are the terms that will have in the questions. Thereafter, we should do the comparing of the fractions. What are the terms that will have in the question? Okay, so first of all, we will say these terms. So what are the terms that will have in the question? That means you have to think that you have to compare two fractions. What are the terms in the question? If you will have arranged in ascending order, that means you have to think that you have to do compare two fractions. Arrange in descending order, that means you have to think you have to do the compare two fractions. Whenever you will have in the question greatest fraction, find out the greatest fraction, that means also you have to compare two fractions. And whenever you will have smallest fractions, okay, then also you have to do compare two fractions. That means in the question, if you will get this type of terms, that means you have to think that you have to do compare two fractions. Okay, so there are too many ways for comparing two fractions. So one by one, we will see all the ways. So first of all, pause the video to note it down, then we will go forward. So what is the first way to compare two fractions? I have written here two fractions, but whenever you will have more than two fractions, same thing you have to do there also. Okay, so what is the first way, very first way to compare the fractions? The name of the way is what? Converting two fractions, converting the fractions in decimal. That is, try to understand the line, meaning of this line. Converting two fractions in decimal, that means we have to convert the fraction in decimal, then we have to compare. Okay, so let's have an example to clarify it. Okay, suppose I'm taking 1 by 2 and 7 by 3. Okay, I'm taking 1 by 2 and 7 by 3. So first of all, what I have to do, you have to convert these two fractions in decimal, then you have to compare. So if you'll convert in decimal this fraction, how to convert it? Just you have to divide it. So first of all, 0.025 is 10. So 1 by 2 means, that means we can write what? 0.5. and 7 by 3, 3 2 just 6, 1.0 here, 3 3 just 9, 1, that is 2.3333. so we can write 2.33 and it is continuing, no problem. We have taken the two digits only after a point, that means two decimal places we have taken. So now you have to compare these two fractions. Okay, we have converted these two fractions into decimal. Now you have to compare. So here first digit you can see. Here first digit you can see what? 0. Here first digit is 2. So which one is greater than the another one? Obviously 2. 2 is greater than 0. So that means this number will be greater than this one. Therefore 2.33 greater than 0.5. that means what? 2.33 and corresponding fraction of 2.33, what? 7 by 3 greater than 1 by 2. Okay, so this is the first way to compare the fractions. Okay, now we will show the another ways to compare the fractions. So first of all, you will pause the video to note it down, then we will go forward. Now we will talk about the second way to compare the fractions. The second way to compare the fraction is what? By multiplying the fractions with the LCM of the denominator. Okay, of the denominators. Okay, what is the way, name of the way? By multiplying the fractions with the LCM of the denominators. So first of all, we are taking some examples. So first of all, 1 by 2, 3 by 7, 5 by 14. Suppose we have taken 3 fractions and you have to find out the greatest fractions, or you have to find out the smallest fractions, or you have to arrange it in ascending or we have to arrange it in descending order. So first of all, what I have to do, we are talking about the multiplying the fractions with the LCM of the denominator. So first of all, we will find out the LCM of the denominator. Okay, so what are the denominators here? 2, 7, 14. So find it out the LCM, and this LCM you will find in the rough, not here. Okay, so first of all, 2 1 2 7 2 7 14. Now 7 1 7 7 1 and 7 1 7 7 1 7. So what is the LCM? 14. So therefore LCM of 2 7 14 is 14. Now what I have to do, we have to multiply the fractions with the LCM. So that means 1 by 2 into LCM, that means 14. First fractions into LCM. Now second fraction into LCM, second fraction into LCM, and third fraction into LCM. Okay, so now 2 7 14. So 7 into 1 7 7 2 14 2 3 6 14 1 14. So 5 1 5. Now you have to compare these three numbers, and according these three numbers you have to write down the fraction. So suppose we are writing the greatest fraction first. Greatest fraction. Okay, so what is the greatest number here? You can see 7 is the greatest number we have got. So what is the corresponding fraction of 7? That means from which fraction 7 has come. You can see 7 has come from this fraction, that means half. So that means half will be the greatest fraction. The number which is greatest, the corresponding fraction will be the greatest fraction. Now we are finding the smallest fraction. Smallest fraction. So which is the smallest number here? Obviously 5. Among these three numbers, 6, 7, 5, 5 is the smallest number. And what is the corresponding fraction of 5? 5 by 14. That means this 5 has come from 5 by 14. So the corresponding fraction of the smallest number will be the smallest fraction. That means it will be 5 by 14. Clear? Now suppose we have to arrange in ascending order. Okay, we have to arrange in ascending order. So ascending means what? Small to big. So what is the smallest number here? 5. So at the place of 5, we have to write which fraction? 5 by 14. Okay, now after that it is 6. That means 6 means we have to write which fraction? 3 by 7. And after that 7. And 7 means we have to write which fraction? 1 by 2. But here we have put a comma. But if you put here greater than or less than sign, then it will be better. Okay, it will be better. So whenever we are arranging the ascending order, we are arranging it ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. Small to big, that means this one will be the smallest, then this one. So we have to use which sign? Smaller than or less than. This one will be the smaller than this one. This one will be smaller than this one. So that we have used the smaller than sign. Now suppose we have to arrange in descending order. Descending order. So what I have to do? Descending order means big to small. So big to small means what is the biggest number here? 7. And corresponding fraction of 7 is what? Half. 1 by 2. Then after that 7, it is 6. Biggest number. So 3 by 7. So after 6, it will be what? 5. That means you have to write what? 5 by 14. Now we have put it here comma. So if you put here proper notation like this, then it will be better. So which sign you have to put here? So you can think you are arranging descending, and descending means what? Big to small. That means this one will be big and this one will be small. This one will be big and this one will be small. So this one will be bigger than. That means you have to put which sign? Bigger than sign. This is called the bigger than sign. And for the ascending order, you have to for the descending order, you have to use this sign. You should keep remember it, okay? And for the descending ascending order, you have to put which sign? This sign. Okay, and here also you have to put this sign. So this is the second way. This is the second way, that is by multiplying the fraction, with the LCM of the denominators. Okay, so first of all, pause the video to note it down, then we will come to the next thing. Now we will know about the third way to compare the fraction. So what is the third way to compare the fraction? By making the denominators same. Name of the third way to compare the fraction is what? By making the denominators same. That means we have to make the denominators first same. So first of all, we are taking an example. That is, suppose 1 by 2, 5 by suppose 6, 8 by 3. Okay, we have taken 3 fractions, and now we have to compare these 3 fractions. And by which method? By taking the denominator same, by making the denominator same. That means what? We have to make all the denominators same, then we have to compare. Okay, so what is the way to to make the denominator same? What is the process we have to do to make the denominator same? This way, that means the third way and the second way that we have done, these two ways are little bit same. So what I have to do? First of all, you have to find out the LCM of the fractions, LCM of the denominators. Okay, first of all, you have to find out the LCM of the denominators. So what are the denominators here? 2, 6, 3. So 2, 1, 2, 3, 6, 3, same. Now 3, 1, 3, 3, 3. Sorry, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3. So 3, 2, 6. So what is the LCM? Therefore, LCM of 2, 6, 3 will be what? 6. We have got. Now what I have to do? Now, you have to divide the LCM by each and every denominators. You have to divide the LCM by each and every denominators. You have got the LCM is what? 6. Now 6 divide the first denominator is what? 2. That means what? 3. Now 6, this LCM divide the second denominator. 6, 1 just 6. Now this 6 LCM divide the third denominator, 3, 2, 6. So what we have done here? We have divide the LCM by the each and every denominators. Okay, so what we have got here? By the first denominator we have divide, so we have got 3, and by the second denominator we have got 1, and by the third denominator we have got 2. Now what I have to do? Now we have to write first all the fractions that you are given. 1 by 2, 5 by 6, and 8 by 3. Now you have to take a line big this much, because what are we are doing here? Whenever we have divided the LCM by the first denominator, so we have got what? 3. So this 3 we have to multiply with the denominator and with the numerator of the first fraction both. That means by the first denominator we have got what? Whenever we have divided the LCM by the first denominator, so we have got what? 3. So this 3 we have to multiply 1 and 2, both numbers. So 3 1 ja 3, 3 2 ja 6. Now by the second denominator, when you have divided, then we have got what? 1. So this 1 you have to multiply with the both numerator and denominator with this fraction. So you have got what? 1. So 1 into 1. So 5 1 is 5 and 6 1 is 6. And here also same thing we have to do. 8 by 3, when we have divided the LCM by 3, then we have got 2, then this 2 we have to multiply with the with this 2 numerator and denominator of this fraction. So 2 2, okay, so 8 2 is 16, 3 2 is 6. Okay, now you have seen, you can see that all the denominators you have got same. Here 6 denominator, here 6 denominator, here 6 denominator, all the denominators are same. So that I have given here, by making the denominators same, means after doing this process you will get the denominator same. And if you will not get the denominator same, that means you have to think you are wrong somewhere, you have done the mistake. Okay, otherwise if you will not do any mistake, then obviously you will get all the denominators same. So what we have done here again, once we will see, first of all we have found the LCM of the denominators. Okay, then we have divided the LCM by each denominator. Okay, 6 by 2, 6 divided by 2, then 6 divided by 6, then 6 divided by 3. Now what I have done, whenever we have divided the LCM by the first denominator, we have got 3, then this 3 we have multiplied with this numerator and denominator also. And whenever we have divided this LCM by the second denominator, so we have got 1. Now this one we have multiplied with the 5 and 6 also. Now whenever we have divided the LCM by the third denominator and we have got what, 2, this 2 we have multiplied with the 8 and 3 both. Now after that, doing this process, we have got the all the denominators will be same. And after doing this process, all the denominators should be same, otherwise you will be wrong. That means if you will not get same, that means you have to think somewhere you have done mistake. So now you can see all the denominators are same. Now you have to compare the numerator. Now you have to compare the numerator to compare these fractions. So first of all, whenever we are finding the suppose smallest fraction, okay, so now you have to check only numerator, not denominator, because denominator you have got same. Now we should not see the denominator. Okay, now we have to check the numerator. So what is the numerator here? 3, here 5, here 16. So we are finding the smallest fraction. So what is the smallest numerator here? You can see it is 3. So that means the corresponding fraction of this fraction, that means 1 by 2 will be the smallest fraction. Corresponding fraction of this fraction will be the smallest fraction. Okay, now we are finding suppose the biggest or the greatest fraction. So what will be the greatest fraction? So what is the greatest numerator here? What is the greatest numerator here? It is 16. And what is the corresponding fraction of this fraction? Corresponding fraction of this fraction is 8 by 3. That means 16 by 6, this fraction has been come from which fraction? It has come from 8 by 3. So that greatest fraction will be 8 by 3. Okay, now suppose you have to find out the ascending order. Ascending means which sign you have to use, small to big, that means this sign. So ascending means smallest denominator, which one? 3. So for the 3, for this fraction we have to write which one? Half. Then we have to use this sign. Then after 3, which one is the smallest the denominator? It is 5. That means 5 by 6. And after this, only one it is left, that is what? 16. That will be 8 by 3. Now suppose you have to arrange in descending order. And descending order means we have to use which sign? This sign. That means biggest to smallest. So what is the biggest to smallest? That means what is the biggest numerator here? It is 16. And 16 means we have to write which fraction? This fraction, 8 by 3. and we have to use this sign. Now, after 16, which is the biggest numerator here? 5. That is 5 means we have to write which fraction? 5 by 6. And after 5 by 6, 1 is left only, that is 3. And for 3, we have to write what? Half. Okay. So these are the different ways to find out, to compare the two fractions or more than two fractions. Okay. You have to do only one way to solve a question. That will be easy for you. Okay. And thank you for watching my video.